Hi, would you like to learn how to mail and address a letter in Canada? Welcome to Jen's Studio. My name is Jen, and today I'm going to teach you how to send a letter in Canada. In this lesson, I hope you will not only learn how to send a letter in Canada, but that you will learn a little bit of useful vocabulary to improve your English. Let's get started. When you are mailing a letter, you need to put who the letter is for in big letters in the center of the envelope. So you should write the person's name, and if you're writing a formal letter, you could use a prefix for the person's name. Prefix means letters or words that come in front of something. For example, if it's a man, you could address the letter as Mr., which is M-R. For a woman, the most respectful thing is M-S, Ms. You don't know if the person is married or not married, so Ms. If you know they're married and proud of being married, like some of my friends, you would write Mrs., M-R-S. If they are an unmarried woman and you know this, maybe you're writing a letter to a child, you could write Miss, which is just M-I-S-S. Those are useful prefixes for addressing letters to people. On the next line, after the person's name who you're sending the letter to, you need to write the name of the street and which number of the building it is on that street. So, for example, on this letter I wrote here, I said the address is 123 Happy Street. If the person who you're writing to lives in an apartment, you can write this two different ways on the envelope. One is to write the apartment number first, a dash, and then the building number and street name. Or you can just write the building number, street name, and then after write APT point and the apartment number. APT is an abbreviation for apartment. In English, when we are addressing envelopes, we like to use short forms. So if someone lived on Happy Street, you might not actually see or need to write the whole word street. You could use the abbreviation, which is ST. I'd like to go over some useful abbreviations that are commonly used on letters for addresses. ST is street, RD is road, AVE is avenue, DR is drive, BLVD is boulevard. We also have PL, which stands for place, or SQ, which stands for square, CRES, which stands for crescent, CRT, which stands for court, and so on. After you have written the street or road name and number, on the next line, you need to write the name of the city where the person lives. After the city name, you should put a comma, and then write the name of the province or territory in Canada where you are sending the letter to. Similar to how we have many different abbreviations and short forms for street, road, place, and so on, we also use short forms for the different provinces and territories in Canada. So I'll go through each of the province short forms that you should use when you are addressing a letter in Canada. Of course, you can write the entire province or territory name, but using these short forms will help you to save time. Starting on the East Coast with our provinces, we have Newfoundland, which is NL. Prince Edward Island, or PEI, can just be written as PE. Nova Scotia is NS, and New Brunswick is NB. Quebec is QC. My province, Ontario, is ON. Manitoba is MB. Saskatchewan, such a long name, luckily you can just write SK. Alberta is AB, and British Columbia, I'm sure you can guess, is BC. Then if we go north and take a look at our territories, going from west to east, starting with the Yukon, the code for this is YT. Then we have the Northwest Territories, which is shortened to NT. And finally, the newest territory in Canada is Nunavut. Nunavut is NU. If you'd like to learn more about Canada's provinces and territories, you can do so in a fun video I've made over here. After you have written the city name with a comma, and then the name of the province you're sending the letter to, on the next line, you need to write what we call a postal code. Canadian postal codes are a series of letters and numbers mixed together. Specifically, Canadian postal codes have 6 characters and are divided 3 and 3 with a space between the first 3 and last 3. And they follow the pattern of letter, number, letter, number, letter, number. If you are in Canada sending a letter somewhere else in Canada, after the postal code, you are done. But if you are sending the letter from a different country to Canada, on the next line after the postal code, you should write the word Canada so that the various post offices know which country the letter needs to go to. When you are writing your return address, if you are in your own country, write the return address the same way you normally would for your country. If you're in Canada, follow the same pattern that you did for who the letter is going to, same pattern for your information. So who is the letter from? Your name and your address. So street number and name, city name, province name, postal code. That will go on this part here, on the top left part of the envelope. On the top right part of the envelope, you need to leave room for the stamp. So today, you have learned how to address a letter in Canada. And now it's time for question of the day. Today's question is, tell me about a time that you have sent a letter to someone. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this lesson. If you found it useful, please subscribe to Jen Studio and give this video a thumbs up. Good luck with your English studies. See you in the next lesson.